Hello, Kusto community. My name is Ryan Majitimer. I'm a product manager on the Azure SAMS Analytics team. Today, I'm joined by Brad Watts, who's a program manager on the Azure Data Explorer team. We're going to talk about a common data ingestion pattern. We're going to take some raw data and land it in ADX. Then we're going to transform the data with an update policy. And then we're going to dedupe and do some aggregations with a materialized view. I'm going to hand it over to Brad. Welcome.
We're going to take a look today at one of the most common workflows that happen within Azure Data Explorer. We're going to do this from scratch, so we're going to show you how to build this starting with just a raw table that's already been set up and data flowing into that raw table. So step one, what we want to do is we want to do some transformation of that data and connect it to a reference table to get some more information. Once we have that data transformed into a table, the next step is to deduplicate that data using a materialized view. And then once we have the data deduped, we're going to build an aggregate. We'll build an hourly aggregate today to show how you can aggregate the data with materialized views. So let's go ahead and jump in. Our focus today is on the data process and not necessarily on you having an intimate knowledge of the data that's being inserted into the table or even the KQL queries that are being used to process it. But at the same time, I'll give you a quick overview of what the data is and just a quick summary of what we're doing in the queries so that the flow makes sense for you. So when you look at this, we've got simulated manufacturing data that's coming into this OPC raw table. And if we just take a look at one of those rows in this particular table, you will see that it's a JSON payload that we need to parse. And if you look within there, the first thing we need to do in this is that each one of these messages can have multiple payloads. And so what we need to do is for each record that's in this messages, we want to expand that out. And so what we do is we use MV expand to do that. So we're just expanding that out with MV expand, and then we're projecting the properties that we want from that. And so now if you take that and go down to here, now after we've run this, we've somewhat transformed it. We've got a few columns, but within the payload, we have another array. And if we look at that one, this particular array has our actual values in it. It has the tag ID that goes along with that. And so we also need to expand that out and do some transformation on that. So if we go here, we're gonna do an MV expand on the payload. We get some information and parse into it. And at the end of the day, we project out what we want. And then this tag ID that's over here, we want to connect it to give it a display name. People that are querying this don't necessarily know the tag ID. They know it by the friendly name, and that's in a different table. And so we do a lookup into that table based on the ID and connect it together, and that becomes our tag. And so if we run this query overall, what we come back with is that one row got expanded into four rows. And we have the device ID. And from the device ID, we're going to parse out the short name, which you can see is just part of that device ID. We're going to get the tag, which is the display name, the value, the source timestamp, and the message ID. And so this is what we want to transform and put into our transform table. And so the easiest way, and one thing I always do before I insert or create the table is check the schema. And so you can just do get schema here and make sure that, you don't have dynamics when you should have strings. You don't have strings when you should have integers. And we can see here that it's, in the correct data type for each one of these columns that we expect. And so the next step is to actually create the table that we're going to eventually insert this data into. And a quick way to do that is we don't want to insert data into it. So what I'm going to do is do a take zero here. And then, of course, I don't want to take one here. I can just take the zero at the bottom. And then what I'm going to do is a set command to create a table. Create a table based on that query. So we'll do set. And then what we'll call this is OPCUA telemetry. And then we're going to base that on that query. And so now we can go ahead and run this. And what we're going to do is we're going to create the table with no data in it. And so just to check the table, what I can do is I can do the OPCU telemetry and get schema on that. And you can see that this particular table has the columns that I expect and has the data types. And so now what we'll do is we'll use this exact same query in an update policy so that when data lands in our OPCU raw table, it will run this query and it will insert the results into our OPCUA telemetry table. And so for that, what I always do is create a function first with this exact same query. So all I'm going to do is take zero off the bottom. And then at the top, instead of a set command, we're going to do a dot create command. And we're going to create a function. And we'll just call this OPCUA update. And then it just has brackets around it. So exact same query we used to create the table. We're going to take that take zero off, and we're going to use that query to create a function that will be used in our update policy. And so now we have a function that we can use in our update policy. It's the same query that we used to create the table, so we know that it's going to work to insert data into the table as it lands into our raw. So the next step is to create the update policy. I always start with our example online, and so this is directly from our docs. And so all I'm going to do is go in and modify this to fit our tables, right? So we're here, what we're going to do is we're going to put this on our OPCUA telemetry table, the one that we created. So that's where the update policy goes on. And then the source table is the OPCUA raw table. And then our query is our function that we created. And so this is OPCUA update. And so that's all we should need to change. And so this will add that policy to that particular table. And so now we've created that policy. So what that means is as data lands into our raw table, we're going to run this function to go ahead and parse that out, to do some light transformation, to connect it to the display name for the tags. And we're going to insert that into our OPCU telemetry table. Our next step will be to get rid of any duplicates that may find their way into the telemetry table. And so we can use a summarize with the take any to do this. So what we're going to do is you run just a simple query, OPCUA telemetry, and we want to take any that has a unique device ID, a tag, a value, and a source timestamp. And so anytime that these items are duplicated, we just want to take one of them. We don't care which one it is. And that will get rid of any of the duplicates that we have. And so, of course, you could do this at query time, but it makes some more sense to have this done dynamically. And we can do that through a materialized view. So we'll just use a dot create command to go ahead and create a materialized view. We're going to call this materialized view OPCU telemetry dedupe. And we're going to base this on the OPCU telemetry table. So as data lands in the OPCU telemetry table, we want to dedupe that data. And we're going to use the query that we just ran to dedupe the data as it lands into the telemetry table. So let's go ahead and create that materialized view. And so now we have a dedupe materialized view. The last step we'll look at in the video is to create an hourly aggregate materialized view. So whenever you're bringing in telemetry data and you're wanting to query over a long period of time, you typically don't query the raw data. You're going to query some sort of aggregate. So if you have an aggregate that is queried often, so in this case, we're going to say that we query hourly aggregates a lot, and I want to put that in some sort of dashboard or something like that. I want that to be super responsive and show the results almost immediately. And so in that case, it makes sense to pre-aggregate that into a materialized view. And so when you look at the query that we're going to run, we're just going to query the dedupe materialized view. We're going to get an average, a min, and a max value. We're going to do that based on the device ID, based on the tag, the short name. And then all we're going to do is we're going to bend that source timestamp by an hour. And so if we run this, we'll get hourly aggregates. And what we want to do is we want to create a materialized view. And so this time when we create our materialized view, we're going to call it OPCU telemetry hourly. And this time, instead of being on a table, we're going to do it on top of a materialized view. And we're going to do it on top of that dedupe materialized view that we created. And we're going to use this exact same query. And so now we have the hourly aggregates in the materialized view. So a quick summary of what we accomplished today in the video. So we started with a single table with a column that has all our raw data in there, but that data is not very queryable. So we applied an update policy and did some transformation of that data and put it into an OPC telemetry table, which is now queryable, easy to get insights out of it. Then we took that and we got rid of all our duplicates using the materialized view. And so now we have a dedupe materialized view of our raw data. And on top of that dedupe materialized view, we have an hourly aggregate materialized view that you can query. And we were able to accomplish this in roughly 10 minutes. So hopefully this was helpful for anybody trying to create similar data transformations and workflows within ADX. I appreciate your time and thanks for joining in.
Well, thanks, Brad. That wraps up our video for today. Tell us in the comments, is this a data pattern you're going to use? If not, what kind of data patterns do you prefer? Again, my name is Ryan Majitimer. You can find me on Twitter. You can find Azure Data Explorer on Twitter, AZ Data Explorer. Thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe. We'll catch you on the next one.